The first is devices, the spintronic nanoelectronic devices. Here in this device we are using the electron spin and its associated magnetic moment to write the any data and then to retrieve the any data from the hard disk. The best example of the spintronic devices is the hard disk. We are using this hard disk in all the computers, even in our laptop. See here, there is one pointer. This is called a transducer. We are writing all the information through this transducer on the disk. This disk is made up of the ferromagnetic material. Actually, it's a ferromagnetic material. So we know in the ferromagnet there is an ordered element of the electron spins. So whenever if you want to write some information on the disk, it will align the electron spin in particular direction. Such a way we can store all the information. In the same manner, we can retrieve that data through the transducer again back to the display. The next nanoelectron. Means it will use the optical photons and it will convert the optical photons into the different electronic energy levels. Then it can generate the electrical signals. Some devices we are using as heat detectors. Those devices we are using as heat detectors. So detectors are using to find the electromagnetic spectrum from the sun and then stellar system as well as galaxies. Even from the light sources, some optoelectronic devices is used as a light sources. Example, the laser sources are using the semiconductor quantum structure as well as the quantum dot lasers. So those are the optoelectronic devices. Then some of the devices we are using is controlling the light. So if you are seeing the laser sources, it is having the quantum well structures. Look at this example. In the left hand side of the diagram shows the quantum well structure, the schematic diagram. The top semiconductor material is aluminum gallium arsenide, which is a stationary semiconductor. The bottom also the same material, aluminum gallium arsenide. The center one is the gallium arsenide. But if you are looking at this band gap energy of the top as well as the bottom, one is same. We can call that band gap energy EG. So the center one is having the band gap energy EG prime. So here it will satisfy the condition. The band gap energy of the center material, the EG prime, is less than the top as well as the bottom one. You can see the energy level diagram to the right hand side diagram. Take this is a the length of the material L. Here what we have plotted to the right means we are plotting the length of the material versus the energy. The y-axis represents the energy axis. So the top material, which is having the energy gap EG, the bottom material also having the same energy gap EG, but the center one is having the energy EG prime, which is less than the top as well as the bottom one. So what would happen to the electron inside the center material? Suppose if the electron in the center material, this wavelength of the de Broglie wavelength of the electron, if it is matching with the dimension of the center material, you can call this approximately equal to the few micrometer or 10 micrometer. It's approximate value. If it is equal to the de Broglie wavelength of the electron, if it is equal to the dimension of the material, the electron, it can't move along the particular direction. That means if you are taking this as a z direction, it can't move into the z direction. The another possibility why it is not moving in the particular direction means if you are looking at the in this well structure, you can see the center one, it is looking like a quantum well. What would happen? The electron seeing the potential energy is high. That means electron cannot have enough energy to cross this barrier. That means electron is confined in this center region. This is called a quantum confinement. So we are using this structure to generate the laser photons by the stimulated emissions. As we move on, we can see this structure in detail. The are seeing here, it's a that displays. Already we have discussed in the fourth units the organic light emitting diodes. It can be used in our mobile devices as well as in the monitor. Nowadays we are looking for the LED TVs, and then we are searching for the organic LED TVs. Now the Samsung company is making organic LED TV as well as LG, even so many Thomson. So many TV companies, they are making the organic LED TV. LED means light emitting diode. So in this kind of display, we are using the nano-electronic devices. So I want to show the simple work function of the nano-electronic devices, how it is acting as a display. If you are looking at this diagram, you can see the top layer is the cathode layer, then the bottom one is the anode layer. There is some substrate in the bottom. So in between the cathode, the top layer, the anode bottom layer, there is some two more layer. These layer are organic molecules or polymers. So the for top one is, top green one is MEC layer. Then the orange one is called the conductive layer. That means this is also organic layer. If you want to see the work function, just to look at the right hand side diagram. Suppose if we are biasing this the organic light emitting diode, see here we are giving the negative potential to the cathode, the metal cathode, the positive potential to the anode. What would happen? That metal cathode will emit the electron into the four electron transporting layer. Usually the emission layer is called electron transporting layer. At the same time, the bottom anode, it will emit the positive holes in the whole injection layer. So in the organic emitter, what would happen? This electron as well as the holes from the anode, it will recombine each other. It will emit the photon. So at the particular wavelength, at the particular frequency. So this will emit in the visible range, so that's why we can see the different color on the OLED screen. Even in this is an OLED structure operation. Then another thing nowadays, these devices are called solar cells and then supercapacitors. Already we saw so many applications of the solar cells. The solar cells we are using for the energy generations from the suns, and the solar cells are most important in satellites as well as in our calculators. What it will do, it will absorb the solar photons, it will convert it into electrical energy. Even if you are sending the satellite to probe our universe, even our own solar system, even other planets. Now we are looking for the life in the other planets. Where is there any life is exist in the exoplanet solar systems? So for those cases, we need the automatic energy generations. In those satellites, we are using the solar cells. Then storing the data, we are using nowadays the supercapacitor, the another nano-electronic devices is playing major role in the storage of data. There are some of the application we are using the nano-electronic devices, like in small projects we are using the nano-electronic devices. And then nowadays people are liking the fitness band. What it will do, the fitness band, it will track our steps, it will track our heartbeats, and then it will track our everyday activities. So and then other advanced and the next generation helping monetary devices, those devices are going to use these nano electronic devices.